Oh, you men who think or say that I am malevolent, stubborn, or misanthropic, how greatly you do wrong me. From childhood on, my heart and soul. You do not know the secret cause which makes me seem that way to you.
To accomplish great things.
From childhood on, my heart and soul have been full of the tender feeling of goodwill, and I was ever inclined to accomplish great things. Misanthropic, how greatly you do wrong me. But think that for 6 years now I have been hopelessly afflicted, made worse by senseless physicians, from year to year deceived with hopes of improvement, finally compelled to face the prospect of a lasting malady whose cure will take years or perhaps be impossible. Though born with a fiery, active temperament, ever susceptible to the diversions of society, I was soon compelled to consume myself, to live alone. If at times I tried to forget all this, oh, how harshly was I flung back by the doubly sad experience of my bad hearing. Senseless physicians, from year to year deceived with hopes of improvement, finally
it was impossible for me to say to people, speak loud, or shall cry in deaf ears,
or perhaps be impossible. How could I possibly admit an infirmity in the one sense which ought to be more perfect in me than others? If at times I tried to forget all this, oh, how harshly was I flung back by the doubly sad experience of my bad hearing. I cannot do it. Misfortune is doubly painful for me because I am bound to be misunderstood. For me, there can be no relaxation with my fellow men, no refined conversations, no mutual exchange of ideas. Such incidents drove me almost to despair. Such incidents drove me almost to despair. It was only my
Dwells the love of mankind, and it is a farewell, and do not wholly forget me when I am dead.